Hi students, today I am going to discuss the day 2 of statistics. This is the second day. I am going to discuss statistics. Yesterday we discussed what is statistics and what is data, why we have to learn statistics. Okay, now today I am going to represent this raw data through a ungrouped frequency distribution table. So here these are the blood groups of 36 students. Blood groups of 36 students. Okay, so the question is like this: prepare a ungrouped frequency distribution table for this data. So observe that here the blood groups are, how we are going to prepare a frequency distribution table for this raw data. So let us take this is a blood group, and now here tally marks, and here you can write the frequency. So what type of blood groups are here? There is the first A, and next that is B, and next blood group is O. And AB is here. Let us take O, and the last one AB. So here four types of blood groups are here. So now we have to write the frequency through tally marks. So here you have to round off these blood groups like this. So here A is here, you have to drop one line, vertical line, and now O, here one vertical line, and next A, next O, here second vertical line, and A, here you have to write the vertical line, and now B, here is B, O, third vertical line for O. Next A, here A, and next B, here it is, and A, here already four vertical lines are here, that's why you have to draw like this. And next B, next O, and next B. Okay, next is second row. This is a O. Here already completed four. B, you have to write like this. And O, here O. And here A, you have to draw like this. And here B. And O, this is B. And this is AB. You have to draw vertical line here, and O, here it is O, and A, here is A, yes, here, and now once again O, here already four vertical lines are here, you have to write like this, and next also O, and next also O, and here is A, you have to write like this, and here AB, and this is O, yes. And A, here you have to draw, and here is B, and here is once again O, and A, have to write like this, and O, and last one is B, is B. So now count the frequency of each blood group. This is 5 plus 5, this is 10. And this is 5 plus 4, this is 9, and this is 5 plus 5 plus 5, 3 5 ja, 15. And now, and this AB, there is only 2. Suppose if you add all these, 9 plus 5, 14, 14 plus 2, that is 16. And here 1 plus 1 plus 1, 36. Here in the problem, these are the blood groups of 36 students. So the frequency is also 36. Total frequency is 36. Okay, like this, the raw data can be represented using tally marks with frequency. This is called the ungrouped frequency distribution. Okay. So sometimes if the data may be too large, otherwise for our convenience, sometimes the data may be classified into categories. So when the data is too large, we have to classify it some convenient groups or classes to make it a sense. Suppose if yesterday we discussed the marks of 30 students for 10 marks. 1, 2, 3, up to 10 marks they got. So we want to make the groups of those students. The students who secured marks between 1 and 3, one group. That group requires extra classes. And suppose another group 4 to 5, which is average. And the third group 6 to 10, that is well. So that we want to make the data into certain groups called classes. That is why when the data is too large, we have to make groups. These groups are called classes. That is why today I am going to discuss about group data. Okay. So the second type of data is grouped data. Grouped data. This is sometimes called as classified data. Classified data. Okay. So here to present large amount of data and to make sense of it, we make groups. We make groups. So these groups are called classes. These groups are called classes or sometimes class intervals. Okay. So here, and their size is called the length of class or class width. or class width. Okay, so here to present large amount of data and to make sense of it, we make groups. These groups are called classes, and their size is called length of class or class width. So here the classes are of two types. Classes are of two types. So here each class, so here the classes or the groups are of two types. The first one is inclusive classes. Inclusive classes. And the second one, exclusive. Exclusive classes. So here inclusive classes are non-overlapping classes, and these are overlapping classes. Suppose if you make the groups like this, there is 0 to 9 marks, and 10 to 19 marks, and next 20 to 29, and so on. So here these groups are called inclusive classes or non-overlapping classes. Suppose if the groups are like this, 0 to 10, and next 10 to 20, and 20 to 30, so on here, these are called exclusive classes. Here in each class, observe that the least number is called lower limit. This is lower limit and this is upper limit. So here, observe that the upper limit of this class is 9 and the lower limit of this class is 10. So here, upper limit is 10 and the lower limit is 10. There is no difference between these two limits. But here, 9 and here is 10. So there is a difference between these two as 1. If the difference is there, then these are called inclusive classes. If there is no difference, then these are exclusive classes. The difference between the upper limit of the previous class and the lower limit of the next class. If there is no difference between these two, these are called exclusive classes. So observe that here, one more point, in each class, the least number is called lower limit, and the greatest number is called upper limit. Observe that. Suppose if there is a class 20 to 30, so here this is lower limit and this is upper limit. Okay, sometimes we may get a confusion that if the marks, 9.5 marks were there, what happens? In which class we have to take it? For that purpose, we have to convert these inclusive classes to exclusive classes by making the boundaries, the class boundaries. So we will see one example how to make the class boundaries. So here, for inclusive classes, so what are the inclusive classes? Here we have lower limit and upper limit. Inclusive classes, there is a difference between the upper limit of preceding class and the lower limit of next class. That is why, suppose 0 to 9 and 10 to 19 and 19 to 20. These are the inclusive classes. Suppose if we, so these is called the class. This is nothing but the class. So here, suppose if you want to write class boundaries. Class boundaries, here lower boundary and here upper boundary. How we are going to convert these inclusive classes as class boundaries? So here 9 to 10 there is difference 1. Therefore, half of 1 is 0.5. So you have to write the upper boundary, add 0.5 to this 9.5. And to write the lower boundary, subtract 0.5. So therefore, this is 9.5. So this is the point. Upper boundary is equal to upper limit plus 0.5. Lower boundary is equal to lower limit minus 0.5. These two points you have to remember. That is why here lower limit, that is minus 0.5. So here lower limit, that is why subtract 0.5. So 9.5. And this is upper limit, that is why 19.5. So here once again. So here 20 to 29. Small confusion. 0 to 9. And next 10 to 19. And next class 20 to 29. That is why 20 minus 0.5. 19.5. Here this is upper limit. To convert it into upper boundary, add 0.5, that is 29.5. Observe that these are the exclusive classes once again. The upper limit, of course, upper limit for exclusive classes, limits and boundaries are same. So that is why, so these are the exclusive classes. So that we can drop 9.5 in one of these classes, either this class or this class. Remember that always this 9.5 can be written in this class, the below class is the mandatory. You have to write like this only. So if 9.5 an observation is there, so there may be a confusion for you whether we have to drop in this or this. So you have to write always in the preceding class. Okay. And now for exclusive classes, how we are going to write the boundaries? Is there any difference for the boundaries for exclusive classes? For exclusive classes, so the classes are like this, lower limit and upper limit, that is 0 to 10 and 10 to 20 and 20 to 30, so on, isn't it? Okay. So now for these exclusive classes, there is no difference for upper boundary, lower boundary and upper boundary. So here 0 to 10. And next class is also 10 to 20, 20 to 30. So here these are equal. So therefore there is no difference between lower limit and upper limit, lower limit and lower boundary for the exclusive classes. For exclusive classes, lower limit is equal to lower boundary. Upper limit is equal to upper boundary. But for inclusive classes, these limits and boundaries are different. We have to convert the inclusive classes to the class boundaries to make exclusive classes. So now, what is the class size? The class size is nothing but this is a class. The difference between upper limit and the lower limit is called the class size. Okay. So now take one definition for class size. Class size. What is the class size? The difference between the difference between upper boundary and lower boundary, or you may define the class size in another way, the difference between any two consecutive lower limits, or the difference between any two consecutive upper limits also. Suppose if you take 0 is a lower limit here and 10 is also lower limit. The difference between these two is the class size. Otherwise, the difference between the upper boundary and lower boundary. Here, this is the upper boundary and this is the lower boundary. This difference is also known as the class size or the length of the class width. And one more definition, the class mark or the mid value of the class. Class mark, sometimes this is mid value of the class. Mid value of the class. The average of lower limit and upper limit of each class is called the mid value of the class. For example, so now mid value is nothing but lower limit plus upper limit by 2. For example, what is the mid value of 0 to 9? Mid value of 0 to 9 is nothing but here lower limit is 0 plus the upper limit is 9/2, that is 9/2, that is equal to 4.5 is the mid value of the class. Suppose the mid value of the class 10 to 20 is, what is the mid value of the class 10 to 20? 10 plus 20, 30, 30/2, therefore that is 15. 10 plus 20/2, that is equal to 30/2, that is equal to 15. So likewise, we can find the mid values of the classes also. And next one, based on the range and class size, we can prepare the number of classes. So here one more point is, based on the value of range. What is range? Range of raw data is nothing but maximum value minus minimum value. It is called the range of the data. That is why, based on the value of range and class size. Here in the example we have taken the length of class size is 10, but always it is not required. You may take the class wise for your convenience. If you want to take the class size 0 to 5, that is 5, so then you have to make in that manner only. So that is why, based on the value of the range and class size, we get number of classes. Number of classes for the data. So that implies number of classes is equal to range. Range by class size. Class size. Okay. So with this information, we are going to construct frequency distribution table for group data. Have you got the point? Based on the value of range and the class size, we have to fix the class size. Unless E is not given, we have to fix the class size. And so that we get the number of classes. So first of all, we have to find the range of the data, and we have to decide the class size, and we have to find how many classes are going to be there. With that, we can construct a frequency distribution table for the data. So now, let us take one example, how to convert this grouped frequency distribution table. Suppose here, the marks of 30 students of a class obtained in a test out of 75 marks. So here, marks of 30 students, the examination is for a test out of 75 marks. Were like this. Marks of 30 students out of 75 marks are listed like this. There is 42 marks, 21, 50, 37, 42, 37, 38, 42, 49, 52, 38, 53, 57, 47, 29, 59, 67, 33, 17, once again 17, 39, 44, 42, 39, and 14, 2, and 27, 19, 54, and the last one 51. So these are the marks of 30 students out of 75 marks. Okay, 30 members marks are here. We have to convert this data into grouped frequency distribution table. Yesterday, we convert this data ungrouped frequency distribution table. So, here we are unable to write all these marks like this. That is why, if the data is too, it contains too many observations, we have to make groups to our convenient. That is why first we have to find the range of the data. Here the smallest number is 2, isn't it? This is 2. And the maximum number, what is the maximum number here? This is 67. So here we can find the range. What is the range? Range is equal to maximum value minus maximum value minus minimum value, that is equal to maximum value 67 minus 2, that is equal to 65. Okay, suppose now we have to fix the class size. What is the class size? Here is not given class size.
Suppose if he has given, take the class size as 5, we can make it likewise. But here class size is not given, that is why I am taking the class size is 10. How many classes we are going to get? Number of classes is equal to range by class size. Range by class size. This is the formula I have given. Range 65 by 10, that is equal to 6.5. 6.5 means nearly 7 classes we are going to get. So, what are the 7 classes? What are the 7 classes? How we are going to write the 7 classes? So, here first of all we have to write the classes. Here the classes. And now we have to write the tally marks. Tally marks also, and now we can write. So here make a match space, and here frequency. Here we can write the frequency, that is the number of students. So here the first class must start with here the smallest value is 2. That is why you can start with 2 or you can move 2 steps before, that is 0 to 10. So, suppose and now you have to decide whether the classes must be inclusive or exclusive. I want to take the exclusive classes, that is equal. So here upper limit is equal to the lower limit of the next class, so that we can prepare the exclusive classes 10 to 20. And here 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, up to how many? You have to think of the maximum value, 67. So the class which contains 67, up to that value you have to write 40 to 50 and 50 to 60 and now 60 to 70. It's enough. You can stop here. You need not go like this. Okay, so that is why you must know the minimum value and the maximum value and the class size. Okay, so now we are going to write the tally marks of the data. How we are going to draw the tally marks? Now you have to put your index finger here and mark 42 in which class? Here 42 marks will fall in this class. That is why you have to drop one vertical line here. Next 21, 20 to 30. In this class 21 is there. 50. So here 40 to 50 and 50 to 60 is here. In which class you have to write? In the preceding class, that is 50 is here. 37. 30 to 40, in this class there is 37. Next 42, so in this class 42 is here. 37, in this class. 38, drops in this class only. 42, 42 is lies in 40 to 50 class, in this class. And 49, in this class only. 52, lies in 50 to 60 class. And 38 falls in this class. And 53 falls in this class. And next 57 falls in this class. 47 lies between 40 to 50. You have to write like this. And next 29 in this. 59 in this only. 67, you have to write in this group. 33 in this group. 17 lies between 10 to 20. So once again 17. 39, you have to draw here. 44, so here itself. 42 lies in this group. 39 in this group. And next 14, 14 falls in this group 2, that is the minimum value of this data falls in the first group, 27 falls in this, and 19 also falls in this group, 54 lies between 50 and 60 right here, and last one 51 also falls in this one. So here we have to write the frequency of the data 0 to 1. How many tally marks here? Only 1. That is the frequency of the first class, that is 0 to 10 class. Here our first class is 0 to 10. Next class is 10 to 20. Okay. So next 10 to 20. How many tally marks are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, here the frequency is 4. And next, we have 3 frequency. And 30 to 40, here 5 plus 2, 7. And here 7. 50 to 60, also there are 5 plus 2, 7. And 60 to 70, only 1. Suppose if you add all these numbers, you get 30, isn't it? 3 7s are 21, plus 22, plus 3, 25, plus 4, 29, plus 1, 30. So here, these are the marks of 30 students. These marks of 30 students, out of 75 marks, were given as a raw data. This raw data can be represented as the classes and frequency using tally marks. That is why this representing the data, note this point, representing the data with classes, that is groups and frequency is called grouped frequency distribution table. Grouped frequency distribution table. Yesterday we did the frequency distribution table without classes. Just we are taken here the observations. So the frequency distribution table with observations and tally marks is called ungrouped frequency distribution table. Here it is grouped, means which contains the classes. The classes may be inclusive or exclusive. How you can find the exclusive and inclusive classes? Just here you have to observe these diagonals. If these diagonals are equal, then these are exclusive classes, that is overlapping classes. If there is a difference between these diagonals is 1, then they are called inclusive classes, that is non-overlapping classes. Okay. So in this way you can prepare the grouped frequency distribution tables in your class textbook, that is 9.1 exercise. Okay. So in some problems he may give the precaution, take the class size as 10, otherwise take the classes like 0 to 10, 0 to 5, like that. You have to follow those instructions while preparing the grouped distribution tables. Okay. So now one more topic, this data can be represented, represented through various forms, through various forms. In 8th class and 9th class, in 8th class, you have already seen how the data is represented. Let us recall what are the various forms. So those are the first one, bar graph, and the second one, histogram, third one, frequency polygon, and the fourth one, frequency curve, and the fifth one, pie chart. So through these, the data can be represented with these forms to get clear idea at a glance without telling anything. If you look at the bar graph, you can absorb some ideas. So how, what is the, so here we are going to discuss bar graph, the first one. So here bar graph contains rectangles, histogram also contains rectangles, okay, frequency polygon, this contains on x-axis, here this is x-axis and y-axis, here the class intervals are here. Of course, here mid-values are taken on x-axis, and y-axis here frequency. Then in the frequency curve also, here we have to draw the frequency polygon by taking the mid-values of the classes. Suppose here, these are the points you got. You have to write the frequency polygon like this. Suppose frequency curve, you have to take the mid values on x axis and y axis, and suppose these are the points, just you have to draw a curve with a free hand like this. And pie chart contains this circle with different sectors. Okay, here bar graph contains like this. So here this is x axis and y axis, and there is bars. So on x axis we have items, and here we have frequency, and bar graphs are like this. So there is a space between these rectangles. So we must have equal space between these two. This width of these rectangles are same, but lengths are different. The lengths represent the frequency. So here also in histogram we have the rectangles, but there is no space between the rectangles. They must draw adjacent to each other. Suppose one rectangle is like this, and the another is like this, and another is like this, and you have to draw like this. So here these are the items, and this is the frequency on y-axis. So just we recall these items. That is, the data can be represented through various forms, and this is those are the bar graph, histogram, and frequency polygon, frequency curve, pie chart. All these are learnt in your 8th class. So these are the just diagrams for these graphs and the pictorial representation of the data. In the next class, we are going to discuss about this bar graphs and histograms of your exercise 9.1. You go through it. Tomorrow we will discuss about these graphs. Okay. So what is the grouped frequency distribution table. So yesterday we did the table for the raw data. Of course, this is also the raw data, but here in the grouped frequency distribution table, the representing the data with classes and frequency. The classes are nothing but groups. That is why it is called the grouped frequency distribution table. Using tally marks only, we can prepare the table. While the raw data is given, if it is too short, we can prepare in an ungrouped manner. But if the data is too much, we are unable to count, or for our convenience, we can make groups. Through the tally marks, we can find the frequency. That is why the grouped frequency distribution. After this, the data can be represented using these grouped frequency distribution tables. It may convert into more visible and more information. To get more information, we convert this data in these forms. There is a bar graph. Who does not know about this statistics also can get an idea while seeing the bar graph. Suppose this is the bar graph. Here the items, this is A grade, this is B grade, and this is A1 grade. So here if we look at this graph, oh, A1 grade is more frequency and the A grade is less frequency. So an illiterate person can also find out some information through these representations. That is why these representations are also very familiar to you in your 8th class. Tomorrow we will discuss the bar graph and histogram in 9.1 exercise. You go through it. We will meet tomorrow's class, in the tomorrow class, okay?